Happy Wednesday, everybody. We are more than half of the way through the week, the working week anyway, not the House of Games week. We're nearly halfway through that. Four famous faces, two different winners already so far. Just the one trophy to give away, though, on Friday. Our players this week are Nikki Fox.
Hello, Richard.
Hello, Ignacio Lopez.
Good to see you again.
Ruthie Henshall. And Danny John-Jules.
Third time lucky.
Hello, one. Hello, all. Ruthie, on Monday, you lost a playoff, a tiebreak to Nikki. Yesterday, victory was all yours.
It was.
Does that feel good? Relaxing?
Yes, but this is relaxing anyway.
Exactly.
It really is.
I like to have a completely non-competitive, non-Jeopardy atmosphere. Gentlemen, it's been so close every single day. Mm. Ignacio, surely we're going to have our first Spanish winner on House of Games.
I hope so. If not, is there a House of Games wooden spoon?
Yeah, I guess so. I guess so. But you would have to do an awful lot worse. Oh my goodness. Most weeks you'd be winning the lead.
Right. Yeah.
Danny, close yesterday as well.
Yeah, and it's difficult to beat a leading lady, you know. Mm.
Exactly. Listen, yeah, you're playing. You're absolutely playing your role, aren't you?
I'm playing a blinder. You can't see a thing.
The weekly leaderboard looks like this. Nikki and Ruthie right at the top there on 7 each. But I think it's all going to change around. There's an awful lot going to go on. Shall we take a look at today's prizes?
Oh, yes.
Ooh.
Whoever wins today gets their choice of this lovely lot.
Oh.
There's the toolbox, the scented candle, the coasters, the water bottle and the egg house. Nikki, any of those you fancy? I'm always surprised when I say egg house.
I've had my eye on that toolbox. My dad's a builder. I think he'll love bowling around with your face.
Oh, that's nice. You can give it to him.
Yeah.
OK, what's his name?
Tony Fox.
Tony. Tony, here we go.
By the way,
is the most builder name in history. Ignacio, what would you go for?
I'm going to go for the toolbox, I think.
Yeah,
it's quite a substantial, cool thing. I was tempted by the scented candle, but I'll go.
But come on.
Toolbox, yeah.
Ruthie?
Egg cage all the way.
Egg cage, we're calling it. No, I think,
Egg house?
Whatever it is, we like it. Danny?
So it's just egg storage, is it?
It's egg storage, really,
egg storage. Okay. Yeah, it'd be close between the toolbox and the eggs, I think.
Between the toolbox and the eggs. A life in theatre.
Exactly.
Let's play our first round, shall we? It is... rhyme time. Fingers on buzzers, everyone. I'll ask you two questions at a time. The answers rhyme with each other. Here we go. Here's your first two. Official language of the Netherlands. And what is that? Yes, Nikki.
Dutch and crutch.
Dutch and crutch. It is Dutch and crutch. Next two. Tall monument in Trafalgar Square, completed in 1843. And Lord of the Rings character, originally called Smeagol. Yes, Ignacio.
Nelson's Column and Gollum.
Nelson's Column and Gollum?
Yes.
It is Nelson's Column and Gollum. Next two. What are these? And what is the title of this song? Yes, Ruthie.
Raccoons, 99 Red Balloons.
Raccoons and 99 Red Balloons by Naina.
Brilliant.
Next two. Beatle, who married Yoko Ono in 1969. And what is this? Yes, Nikki.
John Lennon Watermelon.
John Lennon Watermelon. It is. Absolutely. Next one. 2023 Sofia Coppola film about the wife of Elvis Presley and first name of the Queen Consort, crowned in 2023. Yes, Ignacio.
Priscilla and Camilla.
Priscilla and Camilla. Mm. It is Priscilla and Camilla. Next two. Who is this? And what is the title of this song? Nobody fancies it.
I know it's Rita Chakrabarty.
So you know it's Rita Chakrabarty. You don't know the song?
No.
Yeah.
Ruthie.
Rita Chakrabarty, It's My Party.
Rita Chakrabarty, It's My Party. Final question in this round. Rum cocktail with a name meaning strained pineapple in Spanish. And flotilla, a ship sent by Philip II in 1588 to invade England. Yes, Ignacio.
Yeah, we don't like to talk about it, but that was that's the Armada and it's Pina Colada. Yeah.
Pina Colada and the Armada. We call it, over here, we call it the Spanish Armada.
Oh, do you?
You just called it, you just called it the Armada.
Yeah, yeah, because it's the only one, surely. No, yeah. we actually sunk your Armada a few years later. It's actually
you?
A bigger fleet of ships, but they don't teach you that in school over here, do they?
Not so much. Not so much.
I say we like I had any part in it whatsoever. It's a bit before my time.
I love the fact that as soon as it was a Spanish question, I just looked at you, and then the second bit was even more Spanish. That's the end of that round. Let's take a look at our leaderboard. Danny, you had to get off the mark today. Ruthie and Nikki, our two champions, have got 2 points each. We have a leader, though. Ignacio has 3 points.
Yes.
Well played, Ignacio Lopez.
I feel like I'm going to get sounds like that, the Armada, though. That's what it is.
But which Armada? Our next round is... Great Minds Link Alike. It's a pairs game. Danny, you get to choose your partner. Who would you like to play with?
I'm going to play with Ruthie.
You're going to play with Ruthie. Danny and
then
Ruthie are a team.
We got it.
Ignacio and Nikki are a team. In this round, I'm going to show you three film titles at a time, OK? They will each have blank words in their titles. You have to buzz in if you can tell me what the link between the missing words are, OK? And if you get the link, your teammate has to tell me all the blanks. So what links the blanks in these three film titles? Blank Night Fever, blank the 13th, any given blank. Yes, Ignacio.
They are days of the weekend.
Days of the week, yeah, days of the week. I'll give you that. So, Nikki, for the point, can you fill in those blanks?
OK, it's Saturday Night Fever, any given Sunday, the middle one, 13th.
Yeah, I'm going to wish you good luck for this, not bad luck.
Oh.
I don't know what else you can do there.
Sunday. No, I don't know.
Sunday the 13th?
I'm wrong, aren't I?
It is incorrect, I'm afraid. Do you want to buzz in on that, Ruthie?
Friday the 13th.
Friday the
13th. Of course! Oh, no!
Do they get the whole point for that?
They do, yeah. I'm
going to tip this chair over. I'm so sorry.
It's all right.
I didn't think Friday the 13th was going to...
I can't watch horror films.
But saying...
It's my excuse.
I wish you good luck, not bad luck, was... What links are these three blanks, please? Dial blank for murder, easy blank, and the blank files. Yes, that is Ignacio.
Letters of the alphabet.
Letters of the alphabet is correct. Nikki, for the point, can you fill in those gaps?
OK, it's definitely dial in for murder, isn't it? The X-Files.
Mm-hmm.
The middle is...
Yeah.
Is it A?
Easy A. So we think dial in for murder, easy A, and the X-Files. Is that correct? Very nicely done. Well played. What connects these three blanks, please? My Own Private Blank, Sweet Home Blank, and Three Billboards Outside Ebbing Blank. That is Ignacio.
American States.
American States is correct. I forgot you're a movie buff, Ignacio. Nikki, for the point, can you fill in those three states?
OK, so it's definitely Sweet Home, Alabama.
Yep.
Is it Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri?
Missouri.
And is it My Own Private Idaho?
So you think Idaho, Alabama, Missouri? Absolutely, bang on, very well done. Next three films, what connects these blanks? What's Up Blank, Blank Old Men, Blank Gilmore. Yes, Ruthie.
OK, it is like doctors, nurses...
It is not, I'm afraid. Ignacio?
Is it Emotions?
Oh!
It is not Emotions
no?
either. It's a mix of the two.
OK, yeah, yeah. Is it Dwarves?
Seven Dwarves,
What's
we were looking
up?
For.
Okay, yeah,
What's
yeah.
up, Doc?
Grumpy
What's
Old Men.
Happy Gilmore.
Happy Gilmore. Grumpy, Happy and
Doc.
Oh,
yeah, Doc, obviously. What
am I doing? Next one. What connects these three, please? The Blank Express, Kung Fu Blank and Jackie Blank. Yes, Ignacio.
Is it Types of Bear?
Types of bear is correct. Mm. Absolutely. Nikki, can you name those types of bear?
It's definitely Kung Fu Panda. Is it the brilliant film Jackie Brown? Is there an Orient a bear?
You'll kick yourself.
Something Express, the... Oh, I'm sorry, Matthew.
Well, I think we'll time you out.
Tony.
Ruthie.
Polar Express.
Polar, we were looking for.
Yes.
Very nicely done. Well played. You got a point there, Danny.
Good effort.
That's not bad, is it?
Amazing. That's why I played with that.
Yeah. next one. Hedwig and the Angry Blank, the Green Blank, the Whole Nine Blank. Yes, that is Ruthie.
Yes, it is measurements.
Measurements, absolutely, measurements. Danny, for the point, can you tell us the three missing measurements?
The whole 9 yards.
The whole 9 yards.
Green mile.
The green mile.
Angry inch.
Hedwig and the Angry Inch. It's the correct answer, Danny. Well done. Very nicely played. Green mile,
I had to get something
whole 9 yards. Hedwig and the Angry Inch. Final question in this round. What connects these blanks? The Secret Blank, Blank of Dreams, Jurassic Blank. Yes, Ignacio.
I don't want to give the word away, that's the answer. Is it...
Yes, I know what you mean. I'm trying to think what word describes...
Yeah, is it sort of...
Like green,
green spaces. Yeah, I was going to say floral.
Green spaces, yeah. Is absolutely right. Nikki, can you fill in those gaps?
It's definitely Field of Dreams. I love that. Jurassic Park. And I'm going to say The Secret Garden.
Garden, Field, Park.
Nice one.
100%.
Nicely.
Very nicely done indeed. And that is the end of that round. Our leaderboard looks like this. It's going to be another close one today because we have Danny on 3, we have Nikki and Ruthie on 5, and Ignacio on 6.
Yay.
It's in the lead. Are we going to have our third different winner of the week, I wonder?
Drawing away.
Mix it up, though, yeah.
Round 3 today is... Bit of hits. If you will take your tablets out, please, everybody.
Oh, okay.
We are testing everybody's music knowledge. Now, I'm going to play you 1 second of a famous song. If you know it, write down the name, OK? If you don't know it, I'm going to play you 2 seconds of the same song. Again, if you know it, write it down. Mm. If you don't know it, I'll play you 3 seconds. But as soon as you write it down, you cannot change your answer.
OK.
Right.
OK? So, everyone ready to hear 1 second of a song? Here it is. Should we listen to that again? No one's going to go for this. We were going to wait for 2 seconds.
Mm.
Yeah. 2 seconds of the same song? Nikki is in. The rest of us, should we hear 3 seconds?
Please.
The same song. OK, here's 3 seconds. Do you want to hear it one more time, anyone?
No.
It's not going to make difference to me, mate.
Okay, we are ducking out. So Danny's going for something. You're going to leave your slates clean. Nikki went in 2 seconds. What have you got at home for this one? Should we have a little listen to hear what it was?
Oh, my Lord.
Be Famous by Bross is the answer we were looking for. Danny, after 3 seconds, you wrote, we don't have to take our clothes off to have a good time. Oh, no. That is incorrect. But Nikki, after 2 seconds, you wrote...
I wrote... Da-da-da, when will I be famous?
When will I be
famous? Sorry about the writing.
Good girl.
Nikki gets herself a point. Shall we do 1 second of another song?
OK.
Yep.
OK. Good luck, everyone. Here we go. Nikki's in after 1 second. Ignacio, I think.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of the name. I know the song.
Can I hear it one more time?
Yes, please.
Ruthie and Danny, shall we hear 2 seconds?
Yes,
OK,
please.
Here we go. Welcome to New York City.
Oh.
Everyone's got it going around their head now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think.
Everyone in? Let's listen to 3 seconds anyway for people at home, if you haven't got it yet. That feels easier than When Will I Be Famous, and you got that after 2 seconds. So, let's hear what it was. Living La Vida Loca by Ricky Martin. Danny, after 2 seconds, you wrote Living La Vida Loca, absolutely. And after 2 seconds, Ruthie, you wrote Living La Vida Loca or La Vida Loca. So you would be scoring a point. Except I think that these two might have got it as well.
Exactly.
Nikki, for your second point of the round, what did you write in 1 second?
I wrote Livin' La Vida Loca.
Livin' La Vida Loca after 1 second. And Ignacio after 1 second?
I wrote Livin' La Vida Loca.
Livin' La Vida Loca. A point to Ignacio and a point to Nikki.
Wow.
Final question now. Should we have 1 second of another song?
Yep. Yeah.
Here we go.
I think I know what it is, but I'm not 100% sure.
It sounds like so many things.
I might wait. I'm going to wait.
You're going to wait?
Yeah. I'm
not. I've written down what I think is, but I don't 100%. I know the lyrics, but I don't know if this is the title of the song. So
Ignacio is in. Everyone else, should we have 2 seconds?
Yep. Yeah.
Here we go.
Yeah.
I remembered what the title is now as well.
Okay.
It's not what I've got written down.
Oh, really? Interesting. Danny is in. Nikki is in. Okay. So three of you locked in. Ruthie, should we hear 3 seconds?
Yes, please.
Give us 3 seconds. You've been a messin' where
you shouldn't have been a... I know this is wrong, but I'm just going to have to put something.
You've got to go for it. Go for it, yeah. Okay. Everyone happy?
No.
I'm so angry with myself.
Oh, you think you got the wrong title. That's good news for everybody. So let's take a listen. What was the song?
Oh, no! I've just got it.
Boots are made for walking. Boots are made for walking. Nancy Sinatra. One of these days, these boots are going to walk away. So, Ruthie, after 3 seconds, you wrote...
It wasn't musical theatre, so... Darling. I wrote Ring of Fire, which I know is
it's
not
got a very
right.
Similar
bass.
It's not right.
After 2 seconds, Danny wrote... Boots are made for walking. And after 2 seconds, Nikki wrote...
These boots are made for walking.
These boots are made for walking. So you are both going to get a point, except that if Ignacio has got the wrong title. Ignacio, after 1 second, you wrote...
I mean, I started just writing the lyrics, the whole song down. I wrote Walk All Over You, which is not the title of the song, unfortunately.
It is not. It's quite impressive to get it after 1 second, though.
Yeah. Really impressive.
So, I mean, Danny and Nikki, you're definitely getting a point. Would you be happy to give Ignacio a point for that as well?
Yes.
Yeah.
Really?
I like
Thank
the fact
you so
that you waited for Nikki.
Do I get one for trying?
I take back everything I said about you backstage, guys. Yeah. All right, that is...
Danny, Ignacio and Nikki all get a point there.
Thank you, guys.
For walking by Nancy Sinatra. And our leaderboard looks like this. Danny has 4, Ruthie has 5. Look at this, joint leaders at the south end of the studio. Nikki and Ignacio, 8 points each.
Yay!
Wow. 2 rounds to go. Is Ignacio going to get his first win of the week, I wonder? Your next round is... the nice round. Now, on this round, Nikki, we'll start with you. You're going to have to guess the name of a person.
Oh.
OK. The way we'll do this, the rest of you, if you could take your tablets out, please. You'll see the name of that person on your tablet. You need to write down a one-word clue to help Nikki work out who it is. Nikki, you get a point if you guess it, but you'll also give a point to whoever gives you the best clue. Which is why it pays to be nice. Okay, everybody is in. Nikki, you've got to guess the name of a person. You'll have 3 words to help you. Ignacio, the first word is...
Lager.
Oh. Lager. Ruthie, the second word is...
Designer.
Designer. And Danny, the third word is... Beer. Lager, designer and beer. Have you got that at home?
Karl Lagerfeld.
Is it Karl Lagerfeld?
No.
That's what I was thinking. I thought you wouldn't have been able to write Lager.
I think if we both hadn't done a similar one, it probably would have been clearer.
I think you could see the two men.
Stella McCartney.
Yes.
Oh.
Now you get it, Ruth.
Stella McCartney.
Yeah.
That is absolutely amazing. Gents, you have disgraced yourselves there. We didn't get it, but brilliant clues.
Thanks, Ben.
Brilliant clues.
Yeah.
Well done.
We
did. Stella McCartney. Other beers are available.
They're up, yeah.
Ignacio, you are now going to have to guess the name of a person. You'll have 3 clues to help you. One from Nikki, one from Ruthie, and one from Danny.
Does it have to be a real word?
Gosh, that's a good question. Everyone is in. Ignacio, you've got to guess the name of a person. You will have 3 words to help you. Ruthie, I think you said, am I allowed a made-up word? What is your word?
My word is President Miss.
President Miss. That really is a made-up word. Danny. POTUS. And Nikki.
I've realised very quickly that this is a terrible word, because I've just put fit.
Fit.
But I think if you get the person...
So President Miss, POTUS and Fit.
That's the abbreviation, by the way, of...
President of the United States. And we got President Miss and Fit, so now I have to decide whether you've gone for the current First Lady.
Ooh.
Oh, okay, baby.
Or a previous First Lady.
Okay.
I think... based on yours, because I don't know what... Is it Jill Biden is current the current First Lady? I don't know what she looks like. Yeah. I'm going to guess Melania Trump.
Is it Melania Trump? It is incorrect. Michelle Obama?
Yes.
Yeah. OK. Ignacio, unlucky. So, again, we're giving away no points in the nice round.
Right.
Ruthie, let's see if we can get our first one right. You've got to guess the name of a person. You'll have three words to help you.
So our only clue is people.
Yes, it's a person. Doesn't really narrow it down,
right? Yeah, really narrows it down.
Everybody is in. Ruthie, you'll have three words to help you guess a person. Danny, the first word is?
Oh, I wish I was last.
Oh, no!
Musical.
Did you know? Don't say you did that.
Nikki, what's your word?
I've written F1.
F1. And Ignacio?
I put musical.
Musical, and F1. Someone just said F1 is actually officially a word, so you're allowed.
Yeah.
Oh, fabulous.
Musical, and F1. You can get this, Ruthie. I mean, you haven't been in it.
So it's someone who went into Formula One after...
No.
That's a pretty narrow field. Like, musical theatre stars who went into, Formula
One. That's what I'm thinking.
Who's the most famous driver, you know?
Should we time you out?
Yeah.
Can I have a guess? I know what the musical
you're
is.
You're going to kick yourself.
But I don't know if the person is the racing driver or is the person in the musical. Is it Lewis Hamilton?
Correct. Hamilton.
Yeah.
Hamilton in the musical.
Oh.
Do you understand? See, if you'd have got... If F1 would have come first...
Yes, and then musical.
Then you'd have got... It's an F1 driver, then you would have said musical.
This round is going very badly.
Isn't it?
Danny, please, for the love of God, let's get one of these right. You've got to guess the name of a person. You'd have three clues to help you, and then we'll see how the format works.
Right.
Because at the moment...
The reason why we
the
came
The format
here.
Is you write down words, you don't get it, and no-one gets a point. And I promise you, it usually works better than that. Everybody in?
Yeah.
Okay. Danny, we can do this. We can get a point in this round. Otherwise, it's just 5 minutes of wasted television. And listen, I know we've all done that in our time.
Yeah.
But still doing it.
Let's not do it now.
No.
Danny, you've got to guess the name of a person. Nikki, the first word is?
Okay, so I've gone for Padam.
Padam. That's a
Padam.
Good word.
That's okay. A brilliant
I'm already.
One.
I've already
Padam.
Got it.
Padam.
Ignacio.
I've put neighbours.
Neighbours. And Ruthie?
I've put neighbours.
Neighbours as well. So, Padam, neighbours and neighbours. I'd love it if someone else had written Padam as well.
Yeah.
Person. Oh, God. The obvious two, isn't there?
I won't force you into one of them at the moment, but the two names would be...
Kylie and Jason.
Yeah, so which one?
I'd go with Kylie.
Kylie Minogue? Absolutely right, Danny. Yeah. Well done. So we're going to give away points. I think you got it from Neighbours, didn't you?
Neighbours,
unfortunately,
yeah.
I think Padam was an amazing clue.
Do you know what? Amazing if I knew the
but
song.
Yeah. Danny got it from Ignacio and Ruthie.
Yeah.
So we finally end with a point. Well done, everyone. Tablets away.
Nice. Thank you.
One round to go before we find our Wednesday champion. Our leaderboard looks like this. Danny has got 5. Tuesday's champion Ruthie has got 6. Monday's champion Nikki has got 8. Ignacio Lopez, 9 points.
Hey.
Oh. Taking the lead into our final round. Are we going to have our third separate winner of the week, I wonder? Let's find out, shall we, as we play. Answer smash. Oh. Fingers on buzzers, everyone. Point for a correct answer, point off for an incorrect answer. 4 points between the lot of you again.
Again?
Been so close all week. Your first category is... TV judges. Those will be the pictures, there'll be clues above. Which character in the Despicable Me film series is a reformed supervillain voiced by Steve Carell? Yes, that is Ignacio.
Gru Paul.
Yes.
Gru Paul?
Yes.
It is Gru Paul.
Oh,
Gru
brilliant.
And Gru Paul. Next one. In December 2019, Mikel Arteta was appointed manager of which Premier League football club? Nobody.
I know the club. I don't know
who
that is.
I know the person, but not the club.
Fancy it, Danny?
I'm just trying to find the link.
Should we time you all out?
Yeah.
I was looking for Arsenal-Alicia Dixon. Oh. That's hard to put together.
Arsenal-Alicia. Oh, my Lord. I knew it was Arsenal. It was Alicia Dixon.
Next one. Which 1969 film musical starring Barbara Streisand as a matchmaker has a title song performed by Louis Armstrong? Yes, Ruthie.
Hello, Dolly Murs.
Hello, Dolly Murs. Hello, Dolly Murs. Hello, Dolly Murs. Hello, Dolly Murs.
That's brilliant.
Next category. Road signs. So what do these road signs represent? The Metropolitan Museum of Art is on the east side of which 840-acre green space in New York City? Yes, Nikki.
Central parking space?
Central parking space. It is Central Park, parking space.
Oh.
Or parking place. Central parking place. Next clue, next road sign. Which song from the Four Weddings and a Funeral soundtrack was a UK number one for Wet, Wet, Wet in 1994? Yes, Nikki.
Love is all around about.
Love is all around about.
Well done.
Isn't it, though?
Well,
isn't it done? Love is all around and round about. This leaderboard is looking very, very interesting now.
Oh.
Next clue, next road sign. Angela Griffin reprised her role as Kim Campbell in the 2023 reboot of which BBC drama set in a school? Nikki.
Waterloo Roadworks.
Waterloo Roadworks.
Yeah.
Waterloo Road and Roadworks. Wow. Absolutely right. And are we done? We are done. Nikki got the last three in a row there. Oh. What has that done to the leaderboard? I wonder. On Monday, our champion was Nikki. On Tuesday, it was Ruthie. On Wednesday, our champion
is...
She's just pipped him by a point.
No way.
Nikki Fox. Well played, Nikki. Ignacio, looking so gutted.
Snatched the defeat from the jaws of victory.
Yeah, you were two behind and you got the last three in a row. Nikki, you've won another prize.
Aww. I honestly don't think smug suits me. It's an unusual feeling, this. Honestly, I'm always last normally.
Listen, don't make it worse for Ignacio. He just lost
you. Yeah, Ignacio.
I'm not even playing good.
Yeah. Nikki, which of these would you like?
Oh, wow. Oh, the toolbox.
Toolbox for Tony Fox.
Yeah, for Tony Fox.
I'll tell you what you started and with, smash. Rhyme Time. Tony Fox, toolbox.
Hey.
There we go. Tony, congratulations. Nikki, congratulations as well. Our weekly leaderboard looks like this. 2 days to go. We've got Double Points Friday coming up as well, so lots to play for. Danny with 4, Ignacio 6, Ruthie 9, Nikki 11. Congratulations, Nikki. We'll see you all here again tomorrow.
Yes, indeed.
Forward to ever so much. We'll see you as well on the House of Games.
Dad is going to love this, Richard.
I honestly would give you money if Tony Fox ever takes that to work.
I'll take a photo and I'll send it
okay,
to you.
OK, brilliant.
I guarantee he'll take it to work.
Yeah.
He will. He'll be so proud of me. I didn't come last on a quiz show.
Tony's going...
yeah. Not on your life, Nikki.